Have you ever started a blank ServiceNow workspace or portal and thought, where do I even begin? Or maybe you have spent hours trying to build that perfect user experience only to feel lost in a maze of options and settings. Well, you are not alone. Today, I am going to take you on a journey from confusion to confidence as we unlock the secret of ServiceNow UI Builder together. I am creating the entire series on UI Builder, whatever I know. So whether you are a beginner or a seasoned pro, by the end of this video, you will be able to create a stunning, efficient workspace. Okay, we'll take workspace for now. Okay, that your user will love. So grab your coffee, settle in, and let's dive into the world of UI Builder. So this will be the first tutorial in our series. So let's understand the problem statement for today. So meet Alex. Alex is an IT champion tasked with building a new workspace for the support team. The first challenge is creating a brand new workspace from scratch. It's like standing at the entrance of the theme park, map in hand, wondering which ride to try first. So we'll dwell into it and we'll create a new, for the agenda will be, we'll create a new workspace today and we will try to add it to this particular workspace thing. Okay, the way you see TechnoMonk over here. And also we will try to add some components top of it. Okay, so let's get started. So I will just go to all. What do you have to do? You have to just go to all. This is my ServiceNow developer instance, which is on Washington release. I don't know. So I will go to all, and then you have to simply go to UI Builder to get started with. So as soon as I click on the UI Builder, a new interface will get opened up. I think the instance is pretty slow today. Let's see. So it's getting opened. And using the same tutorial, you can create a workspace also, or you can create a portal also. Why I'm preferring to go with the workspace? Because for workspace, we have to do some addition configuration, which we don't need to do on portal side. So we can cover those things, those aspects also as a part of this tutorial. Perfect. So this is the interface which we are looking for, and we'll be creating a new experience itself, right? So what we have to do, we have to just click on this create button and we'll select experience. We'll give the name to this experience. Okay. So what we can give? We can give what? We can give UX UI Builder itself. Okay, nothing is coming through my mind. Okay, UI Builder. Now here you can see the app shell UI, right? Now you can create a breadcrumb, app shell, header, app shell, portal, user and workspace, so on. So you can create. So what exactly is the app shell? So app shell, you can consider it is like a template. For example, whenever you create a website, you have header, you have footer, okay, you have some left navigation bar and all those things out. This is app shell. Okay, so what kind of app shell we want? So we'll select U workspace app shell for now. For this, I will not give role for now, and we'll simply create. So it will ask you to open the experience. We'll open the experience, and this is how the experience looks like. Okay, if you want to do the tour, you can do that also, but I don't want to do that now. As a part of next step, what we'll be doing, we'll be creating a page into this experience. Then only it will make sense, right? So over here we'll go and create a new page. Now you can see there are tons of templates out there. Okay, for example, there are KPI detail template, there are guided setup template, there are dashboards, so and so forth. Okay, but for this particular tutorial, I want to create it from the scratch. So let's create it from the scratch, and we'll give it a name as home, because I always giving the preference, the first page as home. That's how it's resonant, that there's the first page, right? This is my practice I used to follow, but you can have your own practice. So I will do continue. Then it asks for the UI parameter. So what exactly is the UI parameter? Have you ever noticed when you open any problem record or any change record, so it will, how exactly it's navigating to that particular record? It's via UI parameters. So basically what UI parameter is, if you look at the incident table, right? So if you want to open certain records, so what will the context for it? It will be slash instant name slash incident slash the sysid of the record. That's how it navigates through that particular thing. So if you want some parameters in order to render the UI builder UI for you, you can add this parameter. We will skip it for now. And we can go to looks good. Okay. We will not add variants also. I will explain what exactly the variants also. So based on audience, you can change the behavior of the page. Okay. That's where the variant comes into existence. Okay. Simple thing. So we'll go with continue. Build responsive, without responsive. We always were responsive. Who wants without responsive kind of thing, right? And it's getting rendered. So this is how the page designer looks like for the UI builder. So you have over here the entire body of this particular page. Okay. Means in body you can add component. This is how the designer tab, you can say. Here you can do styling and all the six page configuration. And if you want to embed the data relationship kind of things, okay, you can do it over here. Pretty simple, right? Now if you see here, we can simply add the layouts on top of it. Okay, what layout we want to add, we can add components also. And so your layout is one thing. I'm just clicking over here in the middle. Layout is one thing and component is another thing. Okay, so if I look into the component, right, you can see all kind of things. Okay, what all things are there. So what we'll do, we'll first add a layout. Okay, we'll add single column layout and this. So this is how the layout got defined. And in that layout, now we will add some component. So we can go with rich text kind of thing. And you can add anything over here. Okay. So let's see what we can add. For example, if I add hi there, welcome to TechnoMonk. T should be capital. Okay. And now I can, it's a rich text editor, so I can make it bold, I can increase the font size, I can change the font. Anything I can do. Okay. If I click over here, I can get more options. I can change the font. What we can say? The color also. And I will just do apply. Now, on the style things, you can change other things also. I want to make it center. I can make it center also. Perfect, right? So, this is how it goes. If you want to add some other things, I will probably I would add two column layout, okay, below that. And here you can add some other things out. Okay, for example, I want to add what I want to add. On this particular side, let me add an image. Okay, and on this side, I want to add audio player, anything you can add. Okay, so this is how it looks. Perfect, right? We can save it out. Now we have built something over here. Okay, some UI thing over here, right? But is it visible on our workspace side? So if I look into this, I don't see right now, right? So we can add it to that particular thing out, right? Because the core intention is like, if we are creating a workspace, it should be visible as a workspace, right? Okay. So I've already saved it out. You can also preview it out from here. How exactly it will look. This is the most important feature, okay? So this is how it will look on desktop. This is how it will look on tablet. This is how it will look on mobile phones. So it's responsive also, right? If you have your own pixels, you can do that also. Now, what we have to do in order to get this thing added to the workspace tab. So what you have to do, you can simply jump onto the UI experience thing. I've already clicked on it. Okay. And I will close this out. And here you will. No. So over here we can see the home is there. Okay. We have seen if we go to the setting, you can build the URL preview and all those things variant. Whatever setting we have seen in the past, we can update those settings from here also. Now, in order to add this particular thing to the experience, what you have to do? You have to simply go to experience. So under now experience framework, there's experiences, right? You have to go over here. And what I will do, I will just do sort by updated. Or sort by created will also work for me. You can see Access Analyzer also build out of UI Builder. Everything is nowadays built out of UI Builder. So you can open this out. And under this experience, now we want to make configure it to the workspace, right? So if you just wait for it to get loaded, come on. Okay, perfect. You can see there's a related list called UX application category M2M. You have to just open this out. Click on new experience category. You can select workspace. Okay. If you want to have it as a portal, you can select portal. If you want it as a workspace, you can select workspace. It's pretty similar. Workspace and submit. Isn't that easy? Right? So we have added this M2M configuration. Now if we have refreshed, let me refresh it out. Still not visible. Should we have to log in and log out and log in? Mm-hmm. Yeah, it is. UI Builder. Why it took time? Because it's creating a lot of things at the back end, right? We have to just add it to the related list. That's it for us. But on the back end, it's doing a lot of things. So now if I click on UI Builder, here we go. Okay, our workspace got ready. So just we have created something on the workspace side, right? Isn't it amazing? It's pretty, who wants to code just what we have to do in the portal, right? And just like that, Alex has gone from zero to hero, building a custom workspace, creating pages, and launching a brand new experience for his team. Imagine what you can do with this tool at your fingertips. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe for more ServiceNow tips and tricks, and drop a comment below with your biggest UI Builder challenge. Your feedback helps this channel to grow and let me create more valuable content for you. Thank you for joining on the journey. Now, go out and build your own amazing something. Thank you.